demonstrate the idea that lies in beneath this algorithm. I have a book, so now I have to carefully put it on this improvised table. Actually, it's not a table. It's a is playing golf. So here we have the decision already made. So if we have a new object in our new object to classify, the object is of course the day. The day has its attributes of weather, temperature, humidity and wind. When we got an answer about the weather, that it is sunny, for example. set that probably won't fit into the picture. So the other set is a test set. Classes of these objects. So I should put it as a figured out classification. Or decisions. For example, that days are getting the appropriate decisions. Yes. months of study, and in the course of study, I should write such a program by myself now, and probably it is also a nice training routine. So, here we have one more train. Outside window. Sorry, this train was particularly loud. Anyway, I have to create a program which performs such a classification. Those are the some writings that I made while I was creating and performing an iterative development of the project. Maybe it has some interesting ideas. Started to draw the user interface, and it of course is not anything great, it's just a draft. So you can hear that there is a set of tabs, and here is a list of tabs. Of course, you have seen various implementations of such a user interface in many of the projects. As far as I see now, it reminds me most of all of the Adobe's software settings menu. So here are the tabs. What is important? What are the important decisions that I made during the development? Is that I put out the types of tabs that should exist in this program. So at first, set is written in CSV file, so we should be able to load and record data back in the CSV file. Who doesn't know CSV stands for comma separated. to classify some other set. Just thought glasses of the first object and of the second object. And then, when we perform the test, classifier gets value of those attributes and tries to figure out the classifier, the classes of this. Not to test all the objects from a given set, subset of a set. So, and it's called training set. Training set is a subset of a big set, and everything else is a test set. So at first we get a classifier from the training set, and then we apply this classifier to a test set. So you can see that with such a method we use just a one set for making a lot of tests. Training set first set and the second classifier can't be used with the first set as they aren't compatible. I basically think that I have made a nice job of figuring out all those dependencies and types of windows. Of course, there is nothing in details that I have succeeded to make or made about any of those windows, but it is clear which every window shall do, and the following should be the process of I should be figuring out the data structure of my program. So what types should there be in details to represent types will be described in the by the means of probably class diagrams or by the means of a particular program language, of course in a very draft and descriptive way, not with a full syntax. And this was also.